Now we take up another problem that involves combined rotational and translational motion. A ball is having a velocity v naught at the initial moment. It is slipping on a rough surface. The angular velocity at this point of time is omega naught equal to v naught by 2r. After some time, the ball rolls without slipping and has a new velocity v. We have to find the final velocity of the ball. Now here it is rolling without slipping. The condition for rolling without slipping is v equal to r omega. So the angular velocity of the ball at this point of time, omega is equal to v upon r. Now at the initial moment, omega naught is v naught upon 2r. So v naught is 2r omega naught. And therefore v naught is greater than r omega naught. So basically we have to help the rotational motion of the ball. And friction will be helping the rotational motion of the ball to increase omega naught and decrease v. So friction will act in the backward direction. This problem again can be solved by two methods. By studying the translational motion and the rotational motion independently. And secondly, by conserving angular momentum about point A. So if you look at the translational motion of the ball, the initial velocity is v naught. The final velocity is v. The acceleration is caused by the friction force. So acceleration will be minus f by m. And let's assume that the time taken is t. So v is equal to u plus at. Right? So v becomes v naught minus f by m into t. This is the equation that we get by studying the translational motion of the ball. The time will get by studying the rotational motion of the ball. So study the rotational motion. The initial angular velocity is v naught upon 2r. The final angular velocity is v upon r. Now torque is caused by the frictional force. So torque will be fr and that is equal to I alpha. Torque equal to I alpha. So alpha becomes fr by I. That is fr by 2 by 5 mr square. 1 r will cancel out, you will get 5f by 2 mr. This is the angular acceleration of the ball. So omega is equal to omega naught plus alpha t. Omega is v upon r. Omega naught is v naught upon 2r. Alpha is 5f by 2mr. Time is t. So 1r cancels out from everywhere. We can multiply by 2. So get 2v equal to v naught plus 5f by m into t. So time becomes 2v minus v naught into m by 5f. So you got the equation for time. And you can substitute this in equation 1. So we'll get v equal to v naught minus f by m into this time, which is 2v minus v naught m by 5f. So friction will cancel out, mass also will cancel out. So you get v equal to V naught minus 2V by 5 plus V naught by 5. Simplify this, you get V equal to 6 by 7 V naught. And that is the answer. So you got the final mass of the ball by studying the translation motion and rotational motion. We can get the same result by considering angular momentum about point A. The initial angular momentum of the ball about point A will be given by the angular momentum of the central mass plus mRV naught. This is equal to I omega naught plus mRV naught. Right? The solid sphere, moment of inertia is 2 by 5 mR square. Omega naught is V naught by 2R. So we get this as 2 cancels out, R also cancels. You get mR V naught by 5 plus mR V naught. That is 6 by 5 mR V naught. This is the initial angular momentum. Now we can look at the final angular momentum. That will be LCM plus mR V. I omega plus mR V is 2 by 5 mR square. Omega finally is V upon R plus mR V. So R will cancel out. We get 2 by 5 mR V plus mR V. That is 7 by 5 mR V. Net torque about point A is 0. Therefore, Li will be equal to Lf. That means 6 by 5 mRV naught will be same as 7 by 5 mRV. So V becomes 6 by 7 V naught. The same answer that we got earlier. So these kind of problems can be solved by two methods. First is by conserving angular momentum about the point of contact. And the second method is by studying the translational motion and the rotational motion of the ball.